All in the game, yo. All in the game.
We're gonna do the chest today. Then I put in between some strength and conditioning exercises. And then we go outside, I got tires there and hummus.
I'm on my way up, you know, so I could have made my name on beating someone like Stephen Bonnaes. But he pulled out about 8 weeks before the fight with the knee injury, so they give me a new opponent. So any win in UFC is very important. Winning in UFC is a win in UFC. I mean, I don't think my next opponent is going to be any easier than Stephen Bonnaes. He's tough, he's Brazilian, he's 11-1. Only difference is he's not really big name in the UFC world, you know. So if I beat him, some people can turn around and beat nobody. If I lose to him, I can turn around. I lost to nobody, you know. I'm training hard, same hard as for Stephen Bonnaes, getting ready, and I'll be there fighting Ronnie Marks. Yeah, the wake up to light heavyweight division is really easy for me. I mean, I'm only walking around like 103 kilos. I got about 10 kilos to lose, but before I start MMA, I was doing bodybuilding. So in bodybuilding, you have to have a very strict diet. So I've done this all before, all my dieting. I know exactly how many calories, how much protein, how much carbs or fat I need to take a day when I need to lose weight on or put weight on. So the dieting for me is one of the easiest parts to getting ready for the fight. For some guys, it's difficult. For me, it's the easiest bit. What I'm doing today is, I don't think many MMA fighters train in the same way as I do, but that's why MMA is a great sport, because every fighter is a different athlete and every fighter is an individual. I mean, I come to this sport from the bodybuilding when I was pushing heavy weights, when I was strong and powerful guy, and it did work for me. It did work for me in the cage when I started. I was overpowering the people with my strength, with my speed. So I never sort of give up my bodybuilding training. I'm still pushing the heavy weights, trying to push my strength up to the maximum level as I can. You know, so I'm doing this on my own, because in my MMA gym in London, Shoot Fighters, I'm training with them just the fighting things and strength conditioning for the fighters. But this one is my own thing, what I do in the week, about four times a week. I do my weights. I'm still doing the chest, I'm still doing legs, I'm still doing back, and I'm still doing shoulders and arms. So changed it a little bit, because the bodybuilding training is not going to be the same as the fighting training. Doing a little bit more reps, doing it a little bit more explosive, but the basics still the same. I'm still pushing heavy bench press, heavy deadlifts, heavy squats, and it does help me. I come from wrestling background. When I'm lifting the guy, I find it easy. I mean, in my camp, I used to spar with people like James Thompson, and he's a big and heavy guy, and I'm a small guy, so I need to be strong to move him about. So yeah, I'm stick to my weights even when I'm doing what I'm doing. Today I'm training chest, so basically I'm just gonna do a bit of bench press, a bit of dumbbells, then maybe some flies, some stretching exercise for the chest, and I'm gonna finish off my day with a bit of conditioning outside, heavy tires, sledgehammer, and a bit of rowing upstairs, maybe 10 minutes, two and a half, three kilometers on the row, see how I feel. So I get my strength in right now and get my conditioning in after.
I do about 90 pounds, which is, I don't know, about 42 and a half, between 42 and 45 kilos, just nice and loose. Get the strength, get the conditioning. It always helps you if you're explosive and strong, if the guy mounts you, to get him off him, to get him off you and stuff. So apart of everything else I'm doing, that's what I do. All my sets I still keep between 8 to 12 reps. So I don't go too heavy on the low reps. Like back in the day when I was doing heavy weights, 3 or 4 reps, that's behind me. I don't need it now. So yeah, between 8 to 12 reps to keep fit, keep strong. Yeah, well, water is in my strength and conditioning is bit of a different story. I'm trying to drink water and through the day, how much as I can, or any fluids.
or eat or calories you burn. I'm training three times a day, you burn so much. I'm trying to put in how much as I can. I'm trying to hit the target, 10,000 calories a day, and how much liquid as I can. In my MMA sparring and fighting training is a little bit different. Through when I'm sparring, my coach is trying to keep me off the water because I didn't get used to bed heavy when I fight. As I don't feel like I need any water, you know, so I can have a water after my training. So, but today is a different kind of thing. Yeah, of course, more muscles you carry, you can quicker you can gas out. But that's why I train the way I train. I'm doing my strength right now, slipping into the high repetition. Now doing my flies and the push-ups, and finish it outside with a very explosive conditioning. Them upstairs, the rowing, as the muscle get used to the repetitions, you know. So if you train them to be big and heavy and slow and getting gas out, that's how we're gonna be. But I mean, it's difficult to keep the size and the fitness in the same time. I mean, I lost loads of size. When I fought my first fight, I was 112 kilos. Now I'm fighting 93 kilos. But you still need the strength and some muscle, so you train for it, you know. So I'm not, like I said, I'm putting my repetitions higher. I'm not here in the gym anymore to lift something heavy three times, because I know in the 15 minutes fight, I can be lifting the guy 20 times each round, lift him. If he's good, he gets up, I'll take him down again, on him, again and again and again. So that's what I train for. Train this every day, every day, every day. To get the muscle used to get a muscle memory working. Thank you, my man. Yeah, the boys from Body Limits and Sonobes look after me. I'm training here for years. They know exactly what sort of nutrition I need to get in after hard training. Like I said, through the training, I'm on high calories every day because I'm burning and all I'm trying to get in. I mean, just this shake on its own is a high calories, high protein and high carb shake. It's like 2,500 calories on its own, right? You got carbs, you got protein. I got here another carb drink. It's just 100 grams of carbs in this drink. I mix it with my glutamine and creatine. All supplements for recovery, regeneration are very important for my training because I want to be smart and easy and ready how much is possible for the next day. So glutamine and creatine on a daily basis. I got my meal, I got another carbs in some fruit. I mean, just this meal on its own gives me just under 3,000 calories. So I eat like this a few times a day. Big, full shake, high calories shake. Good meal, bit of rice, bit of chicken, veg. That's what needs to be done. That's what needs to be done after each training.